सेकेंड ईयर इंग्लिश लेक्चर नंबर 56 टॉपिक मिस्टर चिप्स चैप्टर नंबर 9 आई स्टार्ट इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह सुबहाना व तआला हु इज मोस्ट ग्रेशियस एंड मोस्ट मर्सीफुल। अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। डियर स्टूडेंट्स हाउ आर यू? आई से वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय क्लास एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेस लेक्चर। And beta, as you know that in previous lecture we started your chapter number 9 of Mr. Chips, and I told you that after the death of his wife he was now recollected his all strength and abilities. First of all he started to bid farewell to his job, and he don't want to be work in the Brookfield because he was so much in a great loss and in a great worry. But after the headmaster and the other people, they persuaded him to do his job. So beta, now what do we see? That he had got a lot of changes as his marriage added something to his personality. So in the same way, the loss of his family, it added a lot of thing in his personality. So beta, let's see what is going on next. It was a service that gave him freedom to be supremely and completely himself. Now beta, actually he has spent a lot of time in Brookfield and he has become a very senior teacher. So beta, now he is getting enjoying his place in Brookfield. So it was a service that gave him freedom. Beta, this service, it gave him freedom to be supremely and completely himself. Ki jo hai, he is now अपने आप में, जैसे हम कह सकते हैं कि अपने अंदर जो है वो खुद को मनवा रहा था, ठीक है ना, कि ही इज़ नॉट इन फॉलोइंग और ओबेइंग द यू कैन से अथॉरिटीज ऑफ द ब्रुकफील्ड। सो ही वॉज बिकमिंग हिमसेल्फ द अथॉरिटी विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम। सो ही हैड वन बाय सीनियोरिटी एंड राइपनेस एंड अनचार्टेड नो मैंस लैंड ऑफ प्रिविलेज मीन एडवांटेज। He had acquired mean got the right to those gentle eccentricities that so often attack schoolmasters and parsons. Okay beta, first of all supremely mean eminently, theek hai, and uncharted mean new, unfamiliar, privilege as I already told you, advantage or you can say honor, benefit, and eccentricity, oddness, queerness, strangeness, this infradiyat, individuality hum jisko kehte hain na, to us tarah se। ओके, सो बेटा ही वॉज गेटिंग प्रिविलेज एंड ही कुड नाउ द प्रिविलेज ऑफ दैट पर्सन हु कुड टॉन्ट और हु कुड डू एनी कमेंट्स टू अदर पीपल लाइक स्कूल मास्टर्स एंड पार्सन्स। पार्सन्स किसको कहते हैं? पादरी को कहते हैं, उर्दू में पादरी को कहते हैं। ओके, सो ही वॉज, इट्स मीन दैट बेटा ही वॉज गेटिंग पावर एज कम्पेयर टू द other people because he was now becoming the authority as himself. Okay, he wore his gown till it was almost too tattered to hold together, and he wore his gown till it was almost too tattered. Okay beta, his gown, uska gown kaisa tha? Tattered mean in shreds, torn, jaise phata hota hai na. He wore his gown till it was almost too tattered to hold together. So it was very difficult to hold the gown, the tattered, the scattered gown together because it was not in a very good condition. So, but he still used to wear that gown. He didn't stop to wear that gown. And when he stood on the wooden bench by big hall steps to take call over, it was with an air of mystic abandonment to ritual. ओके बेटा, रिचुअल क्या होती है? सेरेमनी, ट्रेडिशन, कन्वेंशन। ओके, एंड अबैंडनमेंट, सबमिशन, एक्सेप्टेंस। सो बेटा वो किस तरह से कि व्हेन ही स्टूड बाय द बेंच ऑफ अ बिग हॉल एंड व्हाई डिड ही स्टैंड देयर इन ऑर्डर टू टेक द रोल कॉल ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हु एंटर्ड। ओके, सो कैसे वो होता था? दैट इट वॉज विद एन एयर ऑफ मिस्टिक अबैंडनमेंट। जैसे अबैंडनमेंट होती है, मैंने आपको इसका उर्दू का भी बता दी थी, सो दैट यू कैन ईजिली अंडरस्टैंड। सुपुर्दगी, सबमिशन या यील्डिंग मीन सुपुर्दगी, किसी चीज़ की सुपुर्दगी, किसी को ऐसे मीन टू से कि हिज स्टेट ऑफ माइंड यू कैन से इट वॉज गेटिंग हायर एंड हायर डे बाय डे। इट्स मीन दैट ही वॉज फीलिंग the he was feeling his position in Brookfield, and he was enjoying it a lot because he was a senior member of the school. So he held the school list, a long sheet curling over a board, and each boy as he passed spoke his own name for chips to verify and then tick off on the list. So beta, what was his work? That he stood near the bench of the big hall, and then he ticked the name of the students who passed by him and he verified it. Okay, so it was a procedure of taking roll call of the students. The verifying glance mean look was an easy and favorite subject mean topic of mimicry. Okay, mimicry mean mockery, parody throughout the school. So beta, the way he used to take roll call, it had become a favorite subject, a favorite topic of parody for all the students, because the students, they love to do his parody. ठीक है, उसकी नकल उतारते थे. Steel rimmed spectacle mean glasses, okay, and rimmed mean round. ओके, स्टील रिम्ड स्पेक्टिकल्स, गोल्ड शीशे वाली एनक होती है. ओके, सो रिम स्पेक्टिकल स्लिपिंग डाउन द नोज, सो इट यूज टू स्लिप अगेन एंड अगेन फ्रॉम हिज नोज व्हेन ही बेंट ओवर द लिस्ट. ओके, सो आईब्रोज लिफ्टेड वन अ लिटल हायर देन अदर, सो हिज आईब्रोज वर लिफ्टेड, वन ऑफ द आईब्रोज वॉज मोर हायर देन द सेकेंड वन, एंड अगेज हाफ रैप हाफ क्विजिकल. ओके, गेज मीन लुक, स्टेयर, ओके, fixed. So rapt mean absorbed, engrossed, captivated, and quizzical mean inquiring. So his, you can say his way of looking at the student, it was some of them it was quiring and some of them was absorbed, yeah, charmed, yeah, bewitched. So it he had kept with him mixed feelings. Clear? Okay, next. And on windy days with gown and white hair and school list, fluttering and flutter mean flap, wave, queer, fluttering in uproarious confusion. Uproarious mean noisy, loud. Okay, so but and on windy days when the winds blow, so when the wind blows, what happened with gown? His gown, who was already in a tattered form, into say the condition of the gown was not very good. So beta, his gown, it used to flap, it used to flutter, okay, with the air and his white hair and the list. So all these things become a symmetry. They had chemistry among all these things. Okay, there was chemistry among all these things, and the whole thing became a comic dance sandwiched between afternoon games and the return to classes. So all these things get suppressed. Okay, sandwich mean get suppressed under the noise of afternoon games and the return to classes. So beta, it was his daily routine, and on daily basis he did all these things. Clear? Some of those names in little snatches of a chorus recurred to him ever afterwards without any effort of memory. ओके बेटा, अब क्या था, व्हाट वाज द नेक्स्ट थिंग, दैट सम ऑफ दी दोज नेम्स इन लिटिल स्नैचेस, स्नैच मीन फ्रेगमेंट, बिट्स, पीसेस, सो द नेम्स ऑफ द बॉयज ही यूज्ड टू रिमेंबर हिज बॉयज एज वेल बेटा, एंड इन लिटिल स्नैचेस इन लिटिल बिट पीस, पार्ट, फ्रेगमेंट. ओके, सो रेकर्ड टू हिम मीन टू से इट्स came into his mind to him ever afterwards without any effort of memory. So he did not use to recall those names or the names of the boys, you can say intentionally, but unintentionally they came into his mind because he did not remember, but the names, they came in his mind to be remembered. Okay, so Ainsworth, Atwood, Evermore, Babcock, Bags, Barnard, Besant, Veitch, Battersby, Beckles, Bedford, Marshall, Bentley, Best, another one. So Ansley, Wales, Wadham, Wagstaff, Wellington, Waters, Primus, Waters, Skenness, Watling, Vaibhani Web. So these were the names, these were the few names that he used to, that he could remember. Okay? Okay. Lancaster, Lytton, Lemire, Lytton, Bosworth, McGonigal, Mansfield. So beta, where had they all gone to? He often pondered. Often pondered mean he often thought that where they have all gone. Those threads he had once held together, how far they had scattered. So beta, thread mean ke there were the students, there was a cluster of students who was in the Brookfield, in the sky of the Brookfield. So where had they gone? Where had they scattered? How far had they scattered? Some to break, others to weave into unknown patterns. The strange randomness of the world beguiled him. Okay, beta, randomness means disorder. Okay? Beguile him, deceive. Beguile him, deceive. So the strange order of the world, it destroyed, it deceived, it misleaded him. That randomness which never would, so long as the world lasted, give meaning to those courses again. सो बेटा क्या था इसमें बात कि दुनिया की अनोखी द स्ट्रेंज रैंडमनेस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड रैंडमनेस मीन डिसऑर्डर द स्ट्रेंज डिसऑर्डर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बिगाइल्ड हिम इट मिसलीड हिम दैट रैंडमनेस विच नेवर वुड सो लॉन्ग एज द वर्ल्ड लास्टेड कि जो दुनिया है वुड सो लॉन्ग एज द वर्ल्ड लास्टेड वेन एवर द वर्ल्ड लास्ट ओके जब तक दुनिया काम रहेगी गिव मीनिंग टू दोज कोर्सेज अगेन सो would it give meaning would it give something important to those courses again mean to say he wanted to say that the world whenever it is it still live or it remains so would it give credit would it give symmetry to all these threads that have been you can say broken to all the cluster to the group of students who have been scattered so beta he is in a very sad, with a sad heart, he is thinking about the boys who had been scattered in the world, in the randomness of the world. So, beta, it's mean that he had a very soft heart and he loved his boys a lot because in the end, when he got dead, before going to die, he uttered these words that. Although he had no his own, you can say, child, but all the boys of the Brookfield, they were his, you can say, children. So it means that he was a very great teacher, and with the passage of time, he was becoming kind and sympathetic, and as well as a little bit humorous, and he was also enjoying his seniority as well. So, beta, I think it was the peak of his, you can say. Peak of his career as a teacher, as a ek teacher ki tarah ek ustad ki tarah, it was the peak of his career that, and he was enjoying a lot. Okay, students, I hope you have all well understood, and if you find any problem, you can ask me, and inshallah, I will wait for your feedback as well. So, beta, read this text again and again, and also learn the similar meanings of the difficult words. Okay, beta, till tomorrow's lecture, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.